Whoa. Looks like we got hired quite a bit while I was gone. Still not a massive amount of money, but still like a full 1,000 or so. Alright. Let's see if that led to any amount of us getting more experience. I'm curious. Otherwise, I might have to look into more tactics that lead to increased experience gain, because I might be missing something. So here's my main squad that I use on all the main missions. Let's see if they did well. I accidentally did the replay. Shit. This is what happens when you say accept like one more time than you mean to. Mashing buttons. There we go. There's enough fights to watch otherwise. One win! Wow. That's a big deal. One win, 12 losses, so we got one win. Instead of 0 wins, 2 losses. We usually get 0 wins, 10 losses. I got 1-12 now. So that one victory led to a massive increase in experience. Instead of getting 17 or 33, I've gotten 191. Which is kind of a big deal. Not enough to actually level up with anyone up, but it's like the equivalent of doing like one fight during a story mission, basically. So if I can figure out how to increase those gains at all, then that'd be a big deal. But who knows if that's possible. How about everybody else, huh? Let's take a look-see. Yep, all losses again. Back to that 33 experience. All the other ones lost, by the way. A newborn ally to the guild has been invaded. Go with the re-enlisted guild captain and take out the old. I didn't see it at the end. I was like, what's the re-enlist guild? I'm confused. defending newborn. Let's get out there.
Godfrey, how good of you to come! Just knowing you're here puts my heart at ease.
This man is a representative from Newborne. We owe the security of our supply lines to their cooperation. You recall the supply wagon you helped escort? They made that supply line possible.
And you keep that supply line safe. After all, Godfrey, we owe you our lives. If it weren't for you, this town would not exist after we ended relations with Tacherva. We are in your debt. Please, let us know if there's anything we can do for you.
How's your current situation? We got word that some old punks have been causing you trouble.
They've been coming from the west, attacking each town one by one. They seem to be looking for someone, but I can't imagine who.
I'm sure they're looking for Uld's princess. I think it's safe to assume that she has the sword.
Lord Reigns!
What's wrong?
Uld's army has been sighted at a nearby hill!
Speak of the devil. Prepare to meet them in the field.
And so we go. Oh, objective change. This doesn't happen too often in the main campaign. It's usually just go to the end point, the end. So we can't let any enemies reach the defense point. Well, we did a story mission this way. I mean, a side quest this way, so it's not foreign concept anymore. But gotta be careful. So we're just gonna carefully keep an eye out. Things look pretty empty at the moment. Okay. So no one's been established yet. Might be a good time to just go grab a resource. Right, that costs TP, and I don't start off with TP. That was stupid of me. Anyway, let's go deal with this guy. Hey, buddy.
I'm here to end you.
Oh shit, they brought guns. No one told me they would have guns. Ow, pain, ow.
Alright. Just gonna sneak on by here real quick, if you don't mind. How's that guarding working out for you, huh? Their leader's way in the back. Not gonna be easy to target with most of my characters, unfortunately. But hey, I got the guy to turn his back, so... Oh. Oh. Well, that makes it harder to get my rogue behind him.
Shit.
I don't like that one bit. Well, fine. Be that way. I didn't want you to invite me to invite... Wait, what's down there? Is that a chest? There is a chest down there. Weird. I didn't want to invite you to my party anyway. Aha! Finish him? Come on! We made it this far. Is there a safer one? Well, that'll take you off guard, though. Let's use Connor. Surely he can do this without killing our teammate. Yeah. Alright. So far, we haven't stepped into the caltrops, and we took the guy down, so that's good. Let's just try not to hurt ourselves now. That'll be fun. Hey-ya! There goes your guard. Let's see if Connor can follow up accordingly. He's here, after all. And he doesn't like you one bit. Let's try to get you closer to the beginning of the spell. There we go. Murder! Oh. Ooh! That's the only option? Fine. There we go. I'll sacrifice my auto guard if it means taking out an extra unit. So they're down to three now. But they're all, yeah, they're all damaging characters, unfortunately. I guess my guard wasn't going to matter that much anyway if my back was facing them. Self-heal is thankfully a thing I still have. Hello. Nice. Take out the leader and all their future turns are neutered. If they want to spam needles, they're not going to be doing much else their turn. Ah! No! It hurts? Uh-oh. They're trying to knock me back into the caltrops, aren't they? I don't appreciate this. Hey there. You want to back off? One more hit. There we go. That's all I wanted. Y'all seem to be running out of frames. Alright, we're gonna want to do this. There we go. Good as new. And we can probably take him out before anything else happens. Shouldn't be much of a problem. Yep. Juggle! Alright, nailed it. Good round for the team. I believe we all ended with full health. And we're a particle away from leveling. Those are all the things you want to have happen. Back to back. Alrighty. Not much else going on right now. Let's go for that chest. Yeah. Technique scroll. Because no one else is on the map yet. Nope. How long do I have to last? Only 56 turns, huh? That's not very long, actually. The side quest I did that introduced this concept was longer than that, I believe. Well, let's hang out by the central map just in case. So you never know where they're going to show up first. Alright. I'll tentatively head his way, but I don't want to leave the base too much, just in case they take off on their own. I'll let him approach me. Yep. Kind of what I expected. At least I don't have a long trip back, so I can go intercept that guy pretty quickly on my roundabout trip. They're charging their attack balls! Uh-oh. Good thing both melee characters get to go first, so we can get in the way of this. You know what? Since he always goes first, I'm starting to get awfully tempted to just put my tankier melee character on the bottom of the formation instead of the front, because it seems like they always crowd him specifically. Maybe that's because of his position, though, and not because of their position. This bottom row seems to always be open and available. Should I do it? Right now, she's just gonna hit her own teammate, I think. Yay! Archer down. He didn't even get a turn. And she's about to hit her teammate, I think. Oh, no, right. It's the spear user that attacks all the rows, I think. It's these hammer users that specifically attack directly in front of them. Well, I can make this a mess. Yay! How you feeling, lady? Good? Good. Let's see. This one right in front of me gets to go next, whereas the one next to Connor... No, this is Connor. The one next to the other character is going to go after him, so he could attack her. So I should attack this character specifically. Especially since they're the leader. All the more reason. Oh, wow. I made a mistake. Matthew, that's his name. Unfortunately, like I've pointed out before, it's very easy to completely lose track of where the damn reticle is, because the screen's exploding with the particle effect of the spell, and it's actually kind of hard to see. So sometimes I'd have really good turns, and sometimes I have really bad turns. What? What? No! Aw. I could have sworn that character's turn was after this character's turn. Maybe it got rearranged by the friendly fire, or maybe even the assist does that. Either way, taking care of that real quick. And I don't think that their archer's gonna last much longer either. Can I sneak up behind him? That'd be kind of great. Yeah! Back attack! And ranged character attack. At least we'll heal for a good 12? 9. 9. Connor's in a bad way. This is what perfection looks like. Yeah, keep pumping up that constitution, honestly. I'm happy with it going up. All better? Not really, but we can pretend. We should really heal. Where's the next combatant? Oh, shit balls. Aha! I made it just in time. That's about as close as that can get. The good news is Connor can heal at the beginning of his turn. Matthew can heal at the beginning of his turn, at the very least. I'm gonna want to defend, given what we have here. Oh, you're still being affected by something? Oh, we have turn damage. Okay. There's a little heal for me. I'm just gonna go ahead and get out in the middle of this. It's gonna be coming my way one way or another. Might as well accept at this point. Doesn't work that way. We're gonna have a lot of incoming attackers, so I think I just want to get ahead of it a little bit. Let them run through it first. Alright. No one's gonna hit me. We'll try to keep Connor out of attack range. No, I should stay down there. Because the healer's gonna have to go up here to heal. There we go. That should allow me to heal without hitting him, which means he'll heal, but it won't break his guard direction. Ow. Yeah, I don't like it. Oh, the leader's back there. I wonder. Seems not entirely reasonable to target them back there. I could go after the little buff character. Or I could just stay back here. Just accept what hits I can get. This is probably too far back. They'll bounce out of the range of it too quickly. Let's get going. Wow. Actually took him out that fast. I kind of thought it wouldn't fully work. Uh-oh. Oh, guard is holding. As hoped. Why don't you guys just come walk across? Yeah. Ow, but not that bad. But this next one might be pretty bad. Everyone's taking damage every turn. Why would you put a barrel there? Oh, he's healing them all. Well, that kind of nullifies some of the fun, to be fair. I guess I'll just have to run up to you and murder you now, leader guy. Not quite. Connor can get it. He'll be going soon enough. Hello. Just getting a few stabs in here. Got him. Just barely. Alright, how well can I nail this? Because this would be pretty great if I nailed it. Oh yeah, that'll probably work. Ha 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 ha, double kill. Fantastic. That's great. That is great. Alright. Well, I can tell you, when it's great, it's great. How well can I juggle this? Should I try that? Should I try Rock Rise or Frost Zone? Is the question. I'll have more energy for this one. Frost. not quite. Oh, we got an assist, though.
Finish him!
Wow, that went pretty cleanly. I think the needle trap... Well, not initially seemed like it was as beneficial as I wanted it to be. I think it ultimately really helped. Open up that agility. The distinction between agility, between the two bars is slightly odd, just because they can both be spent on your movement. I mean, both can be spent on your attack. Which kind of makes it feel like moving... If they can both be spent on your attack, wouldn't it be best to just, wouldn't it be best to just increase your, multi-direction. Both moving slow? That one's gonna take a long path here. Alright. I'll try to get to the other one fast then. See if that helps out. What's happening?
The princess wasn't here either. Then there's no need for us to hold back. This is the town of those treasonous whelps that stabbed Uld in the back.
Pillage and plunder to your heart's delight.
Not if I have anything to say about it.
Guildworms!
Captain, let's follow the guild leader as well.
I guess we're having a surprise scripted fight. Alright. Whoa, ho-ho, big crew. That's six of them. Why do we go into battle so unprepared is what I'm wondering. Unless I'm missing something, I don't think you can hire troops for normal fights. I think you're stuck with four, aren't you? It just seems weird. It's like, no big deal, we're gonna go fight like, I don't know, like 40 dudes over the course of this mission. Let's bring four people! That seems like a good plan. Those two are charging up attacks. This guy's just doing a... I mean, those two are guarding, I mean, and this guy's just charging up an attack, so of course I'm gonna go after him. Murder his face off. Boom! Rising cut. Alright. Can't really get you at past him, though, in time. I guess I'll just start beating on her. Yay! Hip hip hurrah! Wow, they're squishy. They're actually, like, weirdly squishy. What was that? Was I supposed to walk into that? Because I didn't. But I guess, good try. How well can I make this work? Wow. Whoa. Way more damage than I would have expected, honestly. That's a bit of a surprise. Oh, that's probably bad. Yeah. That said, I think I'm winning the damage curve in this fight. Ooh! They're focus firing. Them doing focus fire is the last thing I want them to do, because it's hard to heal. So many of my forms of healing are just, hey, let's heal the entire party! I'm like, alright, cool. Oh, their leader's out of range, huh? Alright, just gonna walk right up to this enemy unit. We're just gonna act like he's not there. Ta-da, ta-da. Oh, that's two down. Why am I so much more powerful than they are? My characters are only like level 17 and 18. I just gave them an open shot on my caster and they couldn't take them down. That's scary. Maybe the old army just puts 0 points into constitution, like at all. That's my best explanation, at least. Wait. Oh, that guy. I forgot about that person. I literally had to hit the joystick to be like, where is the last enemy? I've been ignoring this person so much I forgot they existed. Bye. It's just you kept guarding and charging, so we figured we could just ignore you for a while and it wouldn't really hurt. Whoa, 15%. That's not bad. Unfortunately, we're gonna want to do a manual heal too. But not bad. Yeah, we're right at or even slightly below the recommended level throughout our party.
It seems that Uld's men have been taken care of. You're still every bit the warrior you were years ago, Godfrey.
You flatter me. I know how old I've become. The guild's future is in the hands of young mercenaries like them now.
Boss, the great Godfrey is talking us up. It doesn't feel half bad, does it?
Eric arrogance is a hallmark of the naive. It means arrogance can turn even the most seasoned veteran into a green recruit.
Haven't heard a proverb from you in a while. Are you back to your normal self, sweetheart?
Yes, thanks to you all.
Boss, there are demons around the town. There's something funny about these ones.
It can't be. Is that... Godfrey, what's going on? Those demons are acting like the ones from 15 years ago. I heard you were severely injured. Is that the reason why?
To Terva, she must have broken Tyrbrand's seal.
I'm sure you already know, but a demon in that state wields power beyond measure. Do not let your guard down.
Is it beyond measure because they're super strong, or beyond measure because it's just kind of hard to measure power of an individual person? Because I'm going to say the second one. I'm not that worried. There we go. The old were pretty easy to repel to this time around, weren't they? The funny thing is that the level itself kind of gave away the fact that these monsters were coming in, because they spawned before the story indicated that they were coming. That one's really far away, so this one seems to be the obvious one to go after. Hello. Gotta get in there and grab him fast so we can intercept the other one. Dark demons. That was weird. She told me a proverb, but it was one of those proverbs that's like... it's not opaque at all. It's got a super clear and obvious meaning because it's just written in like really basic English. But then she felt the need to try to translate and explain it. And I'm like, no, I get it. It's fine. Here we go. Makes me wonder if maybe the Japanese version, because it's a Japanese game translated and localized and everything, maybe the Japanese version of the proverb was more opaque in its language. Because the one in English was really obvious. Like, don't step in the grass. It means, don't step on the grass with your feet. Like, oh yeah, thanks for adding that part at the end. I didn't get it till then. Hello. I heard you were a leader. That really works for me. Thank you. Very handy to know that kind of information. And murder. Oh, wait. Oh yeah, right. It's acid, not poison. I had a brief moment of thinking, maybe it'll be resistant. Because it's a spider. But it's acid, so who cares? Doesn't quite apply. Although there's probably some acid-resistant spiders out there. Oh no! I messed up bad. Now I'm gonna pay for it. No! Wow. Not that damaging, but it was really dramatic and hit my party like 10 times, which is a bit of a surprise. The scale of it was kind of surprising because it felt like an artillery strike. Alright, thank you. Party's pulling it together. Where's the next one? They're getting there. We don't want to dilly-dally. Let's go ahead and I keep mixing up party and quest menu. Here we go. Throw a salve on there real quick. Just to make up the difference. Alright, up we go. Oh! Look at you taking the other path. Totally thought they would take the shortest path, so I was caught off guard by them going that way. So we already have red units spawning off in the distance, so we're gonna want to get on that quickly. Thankfully, the units around here are pretty quick to go down. So far, unimpressed. Oh, here comes the dogs. Counterattack initiated. Oh, poor guy. Gonna have to heal him up soon. Ooh! Bad news, lots of damage. Good news, totally healable damage. Even better news, their leader came out front. Oh, bad news, their leader's not very killable. Oh, this'll do it, though. I was a little worried, but that fixed it. There we go. Now their actions will be reduced. Let's not do that. I don't want to interfere with Connor's movement. There we go. Quick heal.
Thank you.
Like he's all better. It's a really good match to have a character with high health and percentage-based heals. Which one's more damage? Top one. Okay. Let's focus on top guy. Got him. Alright, now we're down to one enemy, just like that. One leaderless enemy. Suddenly the whole thing's a whole lot less threatening. Might be able to just... Ooh, even in an assist. Perfect. Means we don't have to deal with the following attack. Although that might hit him. Nope. No physics fall damage either. Tiny heal, but everyone got a mastery up. And everyone has full health anyway. So that went about as well as it could have gone. Alright, let's find our last new target. 12 actions left. This is probably going to be the last guy that we fight. Top priority is just to get to the goal as fast as possible. We'll have to walk through this guy. I've heard these footsteps before. Wow, that's really specific memory. How do you keep track of that? It sounds like Holly. You have so many injuries! But don't worry, I, Holly, the youngest of the four medic sisters, is here! Now, show me your injuries! And she just heals you automatically. Alright, you guys should be A-okay now. Other patients are waiting for me, bye-bye! Jeez, that young lady moves like the wind. We didn't get to thank her again. Okay, wow, we get 10 free TP and a full heal. So she's just the really thankful giving one. Oh, but the downside. The other ones are reusable. She's not reusable. I was curious about what the downside was. Why am I slamming to the ground dramatically? That's a weird... Was that part of the TP too? Our, oh, maybe it's because our morale's maxed out. Alright, let's do max charge. This should be... This will probably be our last fight of the entire level. No. It's the last level of the it's the last fight of the scenario, because the scenario is about to end in a few turns. But, I'll probably have an epilogue fight. There's always an end-of-mission fight, too. Might as well use Blizzard. We'll get a little closer first, because he heals every turn. That's exactly how close I'm gonna get. Damage! 40% damage, there we go. You were greatly damaged. And now I'm here. And the fight's almost over, so that's good too. Seems like a good idea to damage these guys as much as possible before they get their action. Oh my goodness, they're fast. They're fast and moving first. Wow. They weren't just moving fast on the main, on the board, they're moving fast here too. Okay. Well, as I was saying, it's good to get these guys as injured as possible and get the fight to end as cleanly as possible because of the fact that we know we're going to walk into probably an epilogue fight. I really can't go anywhere, huh? Gonna self-heal. There we go. And I'm just gonna start beating on this lady. Oh, wow. She actually didn't last very long. Disaster Talisman. Alright, let's take out the leader next. Alright, now they're leaderless. Why are they so weak? It's weird. We're the same pet level. I feel like they're weaker than normal, I think. I'm not crazy, am I? Bye, tiny screeching Moogle monster. Alright, let's rock this town. I said it out loud. I shouldn't have said that one out loud, but I did. that one went clean. Only character to take heavy damage was healed, I believe. So we should be... Yeah, we're pretty okay. All things considered. Now let's see the scenario ending. Oh, right, I have to walk around a little bit more, I think. Yeah, we're almost there, though. No one else in town? I'll try to open the chest over here. Oh, was the number on under my feet the countdown? Oh, it is 2, 1, okay. I thought it was my 100% morale, but it's just the countdown. Ta-da!
Boss, the demons around here have all been dealt with.
I wonder what could have possibly changed the demons so drastically.
Could it be the influence of the sealed guardian beasts? I never thought I would see it again. Godfrey, is your sword in their possession?
No. At the moment, we don't know where it is. They seek the princess. They must be trying to conduct the ritual from 15 years ago.
That witch, Taterva. Is she trying to sacrifice Lady Corona as she did her mother?
We citizens of Newborn were once citizens of Uld long ago. We cannot just sit idle and allow this to happen again. Godfrey, gathering information is our specialty. We shall contact the guild as soon as we learn something.
I apologize for burdening you once again. Captain, I will return to the guild at once and prepare a counterattack against Uld. The rest I leave to you.
Captain, there may be some demons remaining. Let's check the surrounding area and make sure the town is safe.
Quest clear.
That might have been one of the easier ones so far. I think it was probably easier than the side quest that was about this kind of mission anyway. 3 level ups right there, nice. Alright, level 19. 1 bit more vitality. Let's go a bit further into magic next. Constitution boost. And action, yeah, that's good too. Trisaber learned. What does that mean? That's exciting. So you've been... Yeah, she's been focusing on... Yeah. Recovery of movement. Action... No, action's kind of pointless because she doesn't do multiple actions per turn. Yeah, I've been focusing on health, movement, and damage resistance. All valid. Movement's really the priority, just to make sure she can get anywhere she needs to be. She doesn't usually attack the enemies, and she doesn't usually get attacked very much. Which reduces how much defense she really needs anyway.
Captain, this way is also sealed by a boulder. There seem to be no exits anywhere. Are we doomed to die and rot in this forsaken place?
You're so quick to give up. A white wolf does not show weakness. This trifling pebble... Just break it and move on.
Amazing! And it was such a huge boulder, too!
Why, yes, I am amazing. After all, I am the leader of the White Wolf mercenaries. It looks like this way leads out. Let's go, Corona!
Yes, Captain!
Ah, fresh air! And no ceiling to bump my head off. We have much to do. First, as a new recruit, I must introduce you to our other members. From here, the fastest route to the guild is through Newborn.
Captain,
Corona, follow me.
Yes, sir.
All out war against the people of Uld? Is it retaliation for what they did?
It's only fitting after what those bastards did to the guild.
Our first emergency summons begins when the guild leader arrives. Naturally, it's causing some commotion.
Captain, the guild leader will return at any moment. Let's take our seats, too.
A lot of rumors have been floating about, so let me just cut to the chase. We are declaring war against Uld. You may think this is revenge for their attack on the guild, but this is not the case.
Guild leader, surely you don't mean... Does this have anything to do with the recent sightings of frenzied demons?
Precisely. Uld seeks to revive Animus, the 4 guardian beasts that were sealed away long ago.
So it's true. What happened 15 years ago will befall us again.
Animus? The name of the 4 demons, as sung by wandering bards. The catastrophe that caused the Empire to split into 4 regions.
The demons of legend exist. 15 years ago, Uld tried to revive Animus and use its power to restore the Empire. By attacking the priestess at the heart of the ritual, we managed to prevent it. The key to the ritual was my sword, Tyrbrand. After the Empire collapsed, the guild was formed to keep a close watch on Animus. We were tasked with overseeing the ruins and keeping peace among the 4 great nations. If Animus is revived, Uld will use it to take over the realm. We must prevent that from happening. I need the help of everyone who calls this guild home.
The battle to come will likely be the largest in the Guild's history. Let's show them what we're made of!
The booze you drink after a job well done is something else. Just, he's so cheerful, and it's always he almost always says something after like a really bad thing happened. Oh, it's become the next day, so I got day 6 and 7 in the same day.